We want to solve the equation 4/9 x equals 5/3. We'll take a look at two methods for solving this equation. 4/9 x means 4/9 times x, and therefore the solution to the equation is the value of x that makes this product on the left equal to 5/3. In order to solve the equation for x, we need to isolate x on one side of the equation. And because x is on the left side of the equation, our solution will be in the form x equals some value, again, so that this product is equal to 5/3. And again, because 4/9 x means 4/9 times x, in order to isolate x on the left side, we need to undo this multiplication by performing the inverse or opposite operation. In order to undo multiplication involving 4/9, we would divide by 4/9. But remember, dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. So instead of dividing both sides of the equation by 4/9, we will multiply by the reciprocal of 4/9, which is 9/4. So we'll multiply the left side of the equation by 9/4 and multiply the right side by 9/4. Whatever operation we perform to one side, we must also perform to the other to maintain the equality. Now looking at the left side, notice how we have a product of reciprocals, and therefore the product of 9/4 and 4/9 will be 1. Of course, we can also show the simplification by simplifying out all the common factors between the numerators and denominators. 9 over 9 simplifies to 1, and so does 4 over 4. So the left side simplifies to 1x, which is just x. Let's go ahead and show the 1x for right now. On the right side before multiplying, we'll also simplify. 3 and 9 share a common factor of 3. There's 1, 3, and 3, and 3 3s and 9. And now multiplying, in the numerator we have 3 times 5, which is 15. In the denominator we have 4 times 1, which equals 4. So again, because 1x is equal to x, our solution is x equals 15/4. Let's look at a second method for solving this equation. So beginning with the original equation, 4/9 x equals 5/3, whenever we have an equation that contains fractions, we always have the option of clearing the fractions from the equation by multiplying both sides of the equation by the least common denominator, which in this case would be the least common multiple of 3 and 9. The least common multiple of 3 and 9 is 9, so for our first step, let's multiply both sides of the equation by 9 to clear the fractions. So we'll multiply the left side by 9 and the right side by 9. If we want, we can write 9 as a fraction with a denominator of 1. Now looking at the left side of the equation, notice how the numerator and denominator share a common factor of 9. So the 9s simplify to 1. So now on the left side we just have 4 times x, or 4x, equals, on the right side, 3 and 9 share a common factor of 3. There's 1, 3, and 3, and 3, 3s, and 9. Notice on the right side we just have 3 times 5, which equals 15. Notice here we have one more step in order to solve the equation for x. Because 4x means 4 times x, to isolate x or solve for x, we need to undo this multiplication by dividing both sides of the equation by 4. Dividing by 4 will undo the multiplication, so we divide the left side and the right side by 4. 4 divided by 4 simplifies to 1, or we can also think that dividing by 4 undoes multiplying by 4, and therefore this simplifies perfectly to x. Let's just write it as 1x temporarily. We'd have 1x equals 15/4, and again 1x equals x, so we have x equals 15/4. A lot of times you won't see this step here, because as soon as the coefficient is 1, we can leave it off. Notice how both methods give us the same solution, but before we go, let's check our solution by substituting 15/4 for x in the original equation. This will verify whether 4/9 times 15/4 does equal 5/3. Looking at the left side, we'll simplify first. Notice how we have a common factor of 4. There's 1, 4, and 4 here and here. 15 and 9 share a common factor of 3. There are 3 3s and 9, 5 3s and 15. Notice how this product simplifies to 5/3. 5/3 equals 5/3, which is true, verifying our solution is correct. I hope you found this helpful.